All right. Yesterday when I stopped, I had filled up and put rock in where the backstop will rest and be resting on. So I put a little bit of rock, ran it over, crunched it down. So now I've got the railroad ties, which will ultimately make up the backstop itself. These railroad ties, my intent is to make a box out of them, almost a perfect square box, but the box will only have three sides. Then I'm going to fill it up with sand. These railroad ties are 102 inches long, and for me to do what I desire to do, I need to cut these, not all of them, but about six or seven of them, down to 86 inches. So I need to take them and do a little bit of shortening. So how do we do that? How do we cut them? Well, there are several methods, and I've got a few that I'll show you over here. One, you could use a chainsaw. Chainsaw, it'll cut through those railroad ties. It'll probably dull up the blade a little, but it'll cut right through them. But getting a precise cut is not that easy. Another method is you could do it by hand with a handsaw. I don't think I've got that kind of energy to expend on doing that. Next method I have is a reciprocating saw or a sawzall. I could do that. And another method you could use is using a circular saw. And I have my old rusty, dusty Craftsman 7¼-inch circular saw. So you could saw all four sides, but the depth of that circular saw will only probably go about 2, maybe 2.5 inches, enough to cut through the a 2x4, but those railroad ties are 6x8s, so I'd have to cut the whole way around, go cut in maybe 2 inches, and then do the remainder with a handsaw or a reciprocating saw. Or, and there still is a lot of work doing that because you've got to rotate the big 2x4 around, and gets to be a little bit of work. I like the circular saw method, so I opted to get the circular saw and use it, but I decided on a circular saw that is made for the business. This is a 16-inch circular saw. This particular one is made by Makita, and the blade, once it's flush on the board, the blade will cut down 6 inches. Perfect depth. Well, in fact, it'll go 6 3/16 inches. That's perfect for me. Now, I've never used one of these. It's a lot of difference between that and this. It's almost like a Tonka toy compared to this big thing here. That small 7¼ circular saw that the Craftsman, is maybe 5 pounds. This thing is approximately 27 to 30, 32 pounds. And it's a little bit of weight to be wielding around with a blade that's moving pretty darn fast. So anyway, caution is the biggest thing, but more importantly, we've got to get this done. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to try to beat the rain and get at least 6 of these railroad ties cut. I've got 4 here now. Okay, I put a concrete block in there just to keep the entire tie from sliding that direction as I'm pushing forward with the saw. We'll try it again. You want to keep that excess wire from this saw over your shoulder. You don't want it dangling down where it can get cut by the blade. Just a lesson learned that from my small circular saw I've learned. Once you do it once, you learn. Okay, where were we? Okay, I've got to level out this side and make it flush at the end, and over there it's almost flush right off the bat. Okay. The eighth layer is on. Got to drill holes and drive the stakes and four more layers. We'll see if I can last that long without getting hurt.